In this module, we will discuss mandatory reporting requirements for paramedics and other EMS providers. Once completed with this brief module, you should be able to identify when paramedics are legally compelled to notify the authorities, discuss how reporting requirements arise from the paramedic's special relationship with the patient, and describe the potential legal liability for failure to report as required by the law. This module addresses principles of mandatory reporting as applied to paramedics. In providing this information, nothing in this presentation should be construed as legal advice. Rather, the information provided is merely a broad overview of this legal subject as denoted within the National Paramedic Educational Standards. Please be aware that every state has different laws that impact EMS agencies and providers, and these laws may change over time by application of legislative action or court decisions. Federal, state, and local laws and other legal provisions not discussed within this presentation may also impact EMS agencies and providers. Additionally, information that was current or applicable at the time this presentation was produced may not be at the time you are watching this presentation, and new laws may have been added as well. Lastly, the legal topics and doctrines discussed within these presentations are not the totality of all laws that apply to EMS agencies and providers. There are numerous other laws and provisions that impact diverse aspects of providing EMS. If you or any other EMS provider has questions related to the laws that apply within the realm of providing EMS, additional guidance and assistance should be obtained from a licensed attorney within your area who has subject matter expertise in the specific area of law in question. As discussed in a previous module, many states have laws in place that require people in certain positions to report circumstances involving the possible commissions of crimes. In this particular instance, we are looking specifically at abuse and neglect. The victims of abuse and neglect are often those who cannot advocate for themselves, may be unaware of the abuse or neglect, or lack the ability to improve their circumstance. As such, these victims are often children or elderly patients. Depending upon the laws in your state, there may also be legal provisions that require the reporting of spousal abuse or domestic violence. Other modules within the paramedic curriculum will discuss the physical and emotional trauma that often accompanies neglect or abuse, so we will not delve into those signs and symptoms here. What we will explore, however, are legal provisions that are commonly associated with these mandatory reporting laws. First, where such laws exist, healthcare providers and those within protective service disciplines, which would include paramedics and firefighters, are often required to report suspicions of child or elder abuse or neglect to proper authorities, which commonly includes law enforcement agencies, although other social service entities may be included in the law as well. In doing so, the law also commonly provides protections against both civil and criminal liability if such reports are made within good faith, and some laws even presume that such reports are made in good faith, which makes it even more difficult for someone to maintain a successful lawsuit against an EMS provider who reports as required under the law. There is no need to worry about violating HIPAA either, as HIPAA allows for the disclosure of protected health information without patient permission when required by law. Those disclosures should still be limited to the minimum necessary requirement, meaning the reports are made to the minimum number of people necessary to actually file the report as required by law. Ultimately, these laws recognize that paramedics are uniquely situated to recognize possible abuse and neglect within the ordinarily closed and protected environment that is a private residence. Because EMS providers are called to the residence, business, or wherever to provide help, they are there legitimately for a legally recognized purpose, which means EMS providers, even if employed by the government, do not need a warrant to see possible signs and symptoms of abuse. Paramedics are often provided a glimpse into the real lives of others in their home environments. This access to families and potential victims of abuse and neglect make EMS providers uniquely situated to help combat abuse and neglect, hopefully before it results in death or other significant harm. Aside from medical signs and symptoms of abuse and neglect, the elderly are also routine victims of emotional and financial abuse by family members and adult children. Given this important societal function, these same laws often provide for penalties when a mandatory reporter fails to report. Sanctions could include monetary penalties or even incarceration, depending upon the state and how the law is written. Within Wisconsin, State Statute 48.981 covers the abuse or neglect of children, with EMS providers included in the list of mandatory reporters. Those who make reports in good faith are immune from both civil and criminal liability. Such good faith is presumed in the law as well, which means the plaintiff in such a lawsuit must shoulder the burden of proving a lack of good faith on the part of the reporting party, which can be a very difficult threshold to meet. Penalties can include fines of up to $1,000 and up to 6 months in prison. Similarly, Wisconsin State Statute 46.90 governs the abuse and neglect of the elderly. While some of the provisions are slightly different than those for reporting of child abuse and neglect, the general duty for EMS providers, who are licensed by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services to report elder abuse or neglect, is still the same. Beyond abuse and neglect, many states also require EMS providers to report certain types of injuries related to other illegal activities, such as stab or gunshot wounds. As mentioned at the start, this was a very short module. While mandatory reporting laws are very diverse, with provisions that vary significantly from state to state, the premise is the same. EMS providers must report suspected child or elder abuse or neglect to the proper authorities. So long as those reports are made in good faith, they are more than likely protected by law. With that in mind, you should now be able to identify when paramedics are legally compelled to notify the authorities under mandatory reporting laws, discuss how reporting requirements arise from the paramedic's special relationship with the patient, and describe the possible legal ramifications of failing to report when required by law. This presentation was prepared by Waukesha County Technical College in Pewaukee, Wisconsin, and is distributed with an attribution, non-commercial, share alike 4.0 International Creative Commons license, copyright 2019 Waukesha County Technical College. For information on WCTC's numerous fire and EMS educational offerings, please visit us online at wctc.edu.